driverless taxi company Cruise has had a bumpy month.
Its autonomous driving permits were suspended in California after a woman was dragged 20 feet under one of its vehicles. The company then paused operations in every single one of its US markets to focus on rebuilding public trust.
And that could be a challenge.
See, as driverless companies try to increase public acceptance of their tech, they're rolling out more and more vehicles onto public roads. But that increases the probability that one of these cars could have an accident that damages the paintwork and the reputation of the technology.
While every safe journey may be one step forward, every collision can be two steps back.
A recent AAA study found that the number of Americans afraid of self-driving technology has actually increased.
So how can driverless car companies rebuild trust after a crash? Okay, so in case you missed it, here's how Cruise lost its permits in California.
On October 2nd at around 9:30 p.m, on the corner of 5th and Market Street in San Francisco, a pedestrian was hit by a car, not the Cruise one, and fell into the path of a driverless Cruise vehicle. The Cruise vehicle braked hard and stopped, and then attempted to pull over to the side of the road. The problem was that the pedestrian who was struck was actually still under the Cruise vehicle, and according to the DMV, was pulled 20 feet forwards at speeds of up to 7 miles an hour. The DMV said this may have caused further injury to the pedestrian.
Now, Cruise said it spoke to the DMV about the incident,
but the DMV said Cruise didn't mention that the vehicle had attempted to pull over. Cruise, however, said it showed the DMV a full video of the incident. California's DMV then suspended Cruise's driverless license to carry paying passengers and, crucially, its license to test on public roads, saying the manufacturer's vehicles are not safe for the public's operation.
So if Cruise isn't allowed to be conducting driverless operations on roads in California, how can it rebuild trust?
It's particularly important that the company does figure out a way, just because California is its biggest market.
That's WSJ's Autos reporter Ryan Felton.
You're not going to ever feel that it's safe until you actually experience it. It's hard to imagine what other sort of scenarios exist to kind of rebuild that trust other than just seeing through that people, you know, experience it.
With its licenses revoked in California, Cruise may have to turn to the other states it was operating in to get back out there and demonstrate that its technology can be safe in the real world.
But there is still a path for the company to resume driverless operations in California.
The DMV has sort of spelled out to the company, it says, steps it can take to get back on the road, get its permit. We don't know what those steps are at this point.
But the fact that the DMV is regulating this industry and revoking real licenses from real robo-taxis in the real world when they have real safety issues is a sign that driverless technology is, in some way, finally real.
Like, it's happening. And barring some sort of like full-scale pullback across like the US, which seems highly unlikely, like this is happening. There's mechanisms in place to kind of take action when something does happen. And I think that's what you're seeing.
Now, Cruise isn't the only driverless car company operating in the US. And while it has been experiencing setbacks, others have been making headway. Alphabet's Waymo, for example, recently expanded its operations across San Francisco and announced that it was offering rides through Uber's platform in Phoenix.
But setbacks for one company can have impacts on the reputation of the technology as a whole. And what's not clear is how much further driverless technology will have to go to convince the majority of the public that it's safe, or how many accidents will happen along the way.
LA's mayor recently wrote to the president of California's Public Utilities Commission to voice serious concerns about a decision to approve an autonomous vehicle program in the city. And there are still those who believe that Cruise has rolled out its technology on public roads too quickly. Cruise, for its part, has since announced that they're taking a number of steps to improve how the company operates, including issuing a voluntary software recall.
The vast majority of things aren't 100% foolproof. That is just the reality here, that we're at a point now where there are companies actually using this technology, actually commercializing it. There's going to be incidents that happen, just like if a driver, a human driver, gets into a crash, there could be ramifications as well.
So while Cruise might not be operating autonomously on Californian roads in the near future, the October 2nd incident is unlikely to be the last incident that an autonomous vehicle experiences on its road to building public trust.